This video gives a grand overview of Chapter 5, which is about machine learning. In this chapter, we learn the basic principles of machine learning. We discuss how a computer can help to understand the structure of messy real-world data. In the first video, we are given a set of data points. The data points are from an unknown function. Each data point consists of an input value x and an output value y. We want to fit a line such that all the data points are as close as possible to that line. We learn how to minimize the error by using the squared error loss. This is known as the ordinary least squares method for linear regression. We also discuss how to compute this linear regression if the data is multidimensional. If the relation between x and y is not linear, we might have to fit a more complex function. In the second video, we discuss how to fit nonlinear functions such as polynomials. And what if some input variables are not continuous but categorical, such as a city name? One way to deal with categorical inputs is to use one-hot encoding. By fitting complex functions, we might be able to perfectly match the training data with zero loss. In the next video, we learn how to separate the data into training and evaluation data. If the training loss is better than the evaluation loss, our function is too complicated, and we are overfitting to the training data. We should use cross-validation to make sure that our model works just as well for unseen data. The mean and variance of the error across splits can tell us more about the sources of error in our model. In the next video, we discuss how the expected error of a model, the so-called bias, and the variance of a model interact with each other. Surprisingly, there is an inherent trade-off between bias and variance. A more complex model will be able to approximate a function well with low bias, and a simpler model will have low variance. Finally, regularization is one way of reducing the total error by finding a good trade-off between bias and variance automatically. To do so, we simply add another term to the loss function, which will try to minimize the complexity of the model. The importance of this additional term can be controlled by a scalar, which is an example of a hyperparameter. We discuss the two most prominent methods, ridge and lasso. Linear regression and its improvements have closed-form mathematical solutions. The best fit can be found by simply solving an equation. However, many complex functions in machine learning cannot be solved explicitly. In the next video, we learn the gradient descent method, which is the next best thing for advanced problems that cannot be solved explicitly. In gradient descent, we calculate the gradient of the loss function with respect to the weights. Then we can slightly adapt the weights against the gradient to decrease the loss. We can repeat this process until reaching a local minimum. Gradient descent is controlled by the learning rate, which is another hyperparameter. As an example, we discuss the least mean squares update rule for linear regression. So far, we have discussed how to learn the parameters of a function. In the next video, we study the other main application of machine learning, classification. We want to understand how to classify data, to distinguish, for instance, pictures of cats and dogs. Classification can be done with binary logistic regression. In this video, we discuss the math behind classification using the sigmoid function, log loss, and softmax regression. Up to now, we only considered linear regression models, potentially squashed by a sigmoid function. Binary decision trees introduce a hierarchy. We keep partitioning the input space into smaller regions. In order to make a prediction, we simply start at the root of the decision tree and apply the decision rules until we reach a leaf, which then determines the output value. Decision trees work for classification as well as regression. Finally, we have a short video about evaluating our success. For regression, we can simply compute and compare loss functions. For classification, however, the loss function is not really intuitive. Instead, we introduce simple concepts such as the confusion matrix and precision recall. We also talk about the ROC curve, which can help us to choose the right classification parameters. Thanks for watching this video.